So I just started collecting recipes, and you know, between the recipes you see all of the things that are the same and all of the variables that people play around with. And I just started kind of like combining different recipes and like, oh, well, that made the dough a little too sweet. Let me knock that back and let me add this. And ooh, this recipe called for this kind of sugar. So let me try that. And I just started combining all the different recipes that I've been collecting and made my own recipe from it. It's about time. It's about giving each stage of the bread time to develop its flavor. And so that is the real variable. That is the trick. It's not necessarily about the ingredients. It's about how long do you let it proof? How long do you retard the bread? What do you boil it in? How long do you bake it? Those are all the things that give your bread or pretzels their unique characteristics. You know, we started out with a salted pretzel and sodas. And then we added an everything pretzel, a sweet pretzel. We started expanding our drink menu. It just organically grew into what it is today. And in fact, we're growing out of the space now. I didn't expect people to come from all over the place. I thought we were just gonna be a neighborhood spot. And I remember the first time somebody took a cab, like I saw a cab pull up to the bakery. They got out as the cab waited, they grabbed pretzels and went back to the cab. That was the first time I realized, like, people are coming, you know, they're coming from other places. Far and away, the most important thing is making people happy and being a place in the neighborhood that people know they can come with their families and get something that has value to them and can be something that they share with their family, and which is what pretzels mean to me. And so when I see families coming and I see kids now that were a year old when we opened and now they're four, and they've always had a pretzel bakery in their neighborhood. Seeing that is a true success to me. Without the immediate neighborhood and community, there's no way we could have survived. Now, I've built relationships here with my customers. I'm on a first name basis. In our original location, we were working out of 400 square feet, and even in that small of a space, it's difficult to maintain quality. I mean, you're constantly correcting the process, and especially with bread, you know, there are so many variables, like what temperature is it outside? What's the humidity? How long did it take you to get them in the oven? So all of those factors play a role in the quality of the product. The team are what makes the pretzel bakery great. They're engaging with the customers every day. We've created our own language inside of the bakery, and it makes it a fun place to work. And I think if it's a fun place to work, that the customers see that and, you know, they respond to that. One of the great phenomenon that has come out of the pretzel bakery is that dogs in the neighborhood pull their owners to the bakery. Not a day goes by that I don't see an owner trying to walk their dog past the bakery, and they're, you know, the dog stops right at the gate and the owners are just like, let's go, you're not going today. Our original location was where I learned how to be a pretzel baker. It was difficult for me to think that I was gonna leave that behind, but it's also exciting that we're gonna be able to expand our menu and offer new things. We can take on more wholesale accounts. We can also do catering orders on weekends where in the old space we couldn't. Now we've introduced a calzone made with our pretzel dough. Our breakfast slider has been such a huge hit that we're really excited to get into more of lunch and dinner sandwiches. We also are hopeful that we'll be able to get a beer and wine license. I love drinking beer, so just as I love to eat pretzels, I hope to share that love of beer with my customers. What I realized